everyone. Myself, Mansi Azizha, and I'm working with Lexis and Company. And my today's topic is divorce under Hindu Marriage Act. There are section 13, 13B, 14, and 15. And what do you mean by divorce in Latin term? It is generated from divorcem, that means to separate. And what is divorce under Hindu Marriage Act? According to Hindu Marriage Act, divorce means a dissolution of marriage. Let's talk about section 14 and 15 first, and then we will talk about section 13 and 13B. According to section 14, when parties can file divorce? Under section 14 of Hindu Marriage Act, parties cannot file for divorce unless at the time of petition 1 year has elapsed since the date of marriage. Exceptional cases can be heard, like domestic violence, torture, harass, or marbeat. Now, what is section 15? In section 15, it is discussed that when can divorced parties remarry. Under section 15, if there lies no appeal to the decree of divorce, or if the time period of filing an appeal has expired, then the parties can remarry. But in all the levels they have to complete for divorce, like district court, they have to appeal, then high court, then supreme court. If 1 or 2 months left for appeal, the parties cannot remarry. If all the levels, all the appeal has done till the Supreme Court, then only parties can remarry. Now, let's talk about section 13. 13.1 and 13.1A. Grounds available to husband and wife. 13.2. Grounds only available to wife. Section 13, Clause A. Alternate relief in divorce proceedings. It's a part of Section 13, but not applicable in divorce. Section 13B, Mutual Consent Divorce. Now, let's talk about the grounds for divorce. Provisions for divorce under the Hindu Marriage Act. 1955 is given under section 13, which gives an exhaustive list of grounds under which a spouse can seek a divorce. In section 13, all the grounds are there for divorce. Let's talk about section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act. 1955 gives power to both the spouse, section 13 clause 1, and to the wife alone, section 13 clause 2. To move before a court and seek the remedy of divorce. Grounds of divorce as per the Hindu Marriage Act are as follows. Let's talk about section 13 clause 1. That the spouse had voluntary sexual intercourse with any other person after marriage, that is adultery. If spouse has sexual intercourse with the other, then there is a ground for taking the divorce. And second ground, that the spouse had treated the petitioner spouse with cruelty. In ground one, adultery, there is a case in which the court held that adultery is held to be not a crime. In 2018, there is a case, Joseph Schein versus Union of India. In this case, it is said that it is a ground for divorce, it's not a crime. Parties can file for divorce. Let's section 13. 13 clause 1 third ground that the spouse has deserted the petitioner for not less than 2 years continuously preceding the filing of the suit for divorce. Fourth ground, that the spouse has converted to another religion and has ceased to be a Hindu. Then a spouse can file for a divorce if they have converted their religion. Now, ground 5. That the spouse has an incurable unsound mind, that the petitioner's spouse cannot live with him or her. If they found that spouse has is of unsound mind, that the spouse can file for a divorce. Sixth ground, that the spouse has been suffering from virulent and incurable leprosy. Seventh ground, that the spouse has been suffering from a contagious venereal disease. Eighth ground, that the spouse has renounced the world and has joined the spiritual world, like they have taken the sannyas, and spouse can file for a divorce. Ninth ground, that the spouse has been unheard for a period of 7 years or more by persons who would have naturally heard of it had that party been alive. Other than these, there are also two additional grounds added to the list under section 13(1)(a). by which a divorce can be sought for on the grounds of non-cohabitation for a period not less than 1 year after the passing of a decree for judicial separation and non-resolution of conjugal rights for a period of not less than 1 year after the passing of decree for resolution of conjugal rights in a proceeding. There are other two grounds, that first is judicial separation and second is non-restitution of conjugal rights. Now, section 13 clause 2. These grounds are reserved only for the wife. Now, the grounds for the wife. First, that the marriage was solemnized before the commencement of the act and the husband had remarried before such commencement or already had a wife who is living before such commencement at the time of the marriage. Second ground, that the husband after the marriage has been charged with rape, sodomy or bestiality. Third, that the bride's marriage was solemnized before she attained the age of 15 years and she has repudiated the marriage after attaining that age but before attaining the age of 18 years. This is the third ground. These all are the grounds for only wife. Now come to the section B, section 13B, mutual divorce. Divorce by mutual consent can be obtained within 6 months, but no petition in such a case can be filed within first year of marriage. If a petition wants to file a case by mutual consent, but only they can file a case with after the first year of marriage. Otherwise, no petition in such case can be filed if only their marriage is between is happened. There also has to be gap of 6 months between the first motion and second motion. This is the proceedings for mutual consent. In case of divorce by mutual consent, it usually takes 18 to 24 months. Thank you. These all are the grounds for divorce, and this is the concept of divorce. And thank you for watching. And please subscribe this channel, lexclick.com. Thank you so much.